Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Jennifer. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to make a rain barrel. It's really quite easy. You only need a couple tools. I'm going to be using my drill, a jigsaw, and you also might want to get a hole saw. Just make sure it's slightly smaller than the diameter of the spigot that you're going to be using. As far as supplies, I used this 30-gallon tank that I had around my property, a faucet from Lowe's, you can find these at any hardware store, a flexible gutter diverter, and a tin bucket with a cinder block as the base. I'll be showing you the one I made about 4 years ago in just a second. It worked great until I came around the corner with my lawnmower and accidentally hit into the faucet and it cracked the plastic. Here's the old rain barrel. It just comes down, has that flexible spout, and here is where I hit it with my lawnmower, and then it caused a crack. The water leaked out, and so it's pretty much been dormant for the last couple years, but it worked great up until that mishap. Now, if you can see, here's the base. I'm not going to go lifting this off of here, but I wanted to give it something so that it didn't sink into the ground, and this actually worked really well. It's a wash tub similar to something like this. I dug down a little bit, put cinder blocks underneath it so that the center wouldn't collapse with the weight, and then put the tub on top of it. That part you're not going to get on video, but I will show you how I cut this and got it set up. This is something I plan to use to water the flowers in my yard, but you could use this for camping, for animals. You could make the faucet a little bit lower than I'm going to be showing you and attach a garden hose as well. Okay, so some things to consider before you do this. I'm going to be cutting a hole in the top that is for the downspout to hook up to, but also I need a way to get my arm into this. Now, I know when I made this a couple years ago, everyone commented because I put the faucet a little bit up off the ground. They're like, well, you're wasting the water that's underneath it. Well, once this fills full of water and every time it rains, it fills up. I never used, I don't know what that was, like 20 gallons of water. Now you might want to do something different, but this is just the thought process. You can take this idea and cater it to whatever your needs are. That being said, I'm going to go ahead and get started on this and show you how I'm going to do it. So I'm just going to put this on here, trace around it, and then use my jigsaw to cut that out. I'm just going to carefully trace the outline here. Okay, so for me to be able to drop the blade in with my jigsaw, I'm going to have to drill some holes. So I'm going to do that. Otherwise, if I don't do this, I won't be able to drop my blade in. And actually, I think my blade is probably thicker than that, so I'm gonna actually probably have to double up. Yeah, see, to get that started, I really need to put a hole right next to that. Okay. Okay, so let's give that a whirl. And actually, you know what I did last year is I filled the top of this just because it looked nicer. I put some stuff on the top. I put pea gravel and planted some chia seeds and it sprouted. It looked really pretty. So I think I'm gonna do that this year too. And also because this is light, I didn't want it to blow off the stand before it rained. Now we are expecting rain. There's a chance of rain tonight. So I think what I will do to keep this in its spot before it rains, I'm going to dump some pea gravel just to give it a little bit of weight, but we'll get to that in a second. So, okay, then the next thing I want to, now if you can see, this barrel actually has a hole here and there's one on the opposing side, but I think I'm going to add a couple more drainage holes along the top just in case there is a downpour. I want that water to have somewhere to go, so I'm going to go ahead and do that right now. So I'm going to do about 4 drainage holes down within the tank. And you can do these whatever size you want. I don't even know. I just picked up that bit. It was on my bench. I don't know what size it is. A lot of this is just the concept, and you can take it from there. So I'm going to do about 4 drainage holes within the tank. I'm just gonna have a seat. This is the actual spigot. This is gonna slip on the outside. I don't have a hole saw that size. So what I'm gonna do is figure out where I wanna put it. I'm gonna trace it. And then I'm actually going to take a drill and drill out a hole for this. So what really worked well last time was to leave it a little bit smaller. And then it kind of gave me, once I started to put this in, it actually kind of left threads in it and it was a nice tight fit. Whereas if you get it too big, water's just gonna seep out. So that is the method I would prefer to use. Or if you use a hole saw, use just a tiny bit smaller. I'm gonna figure out where I want it to go. Here's how this is set up. It's marked 15 gallons, 20 gallons, then up there 30. So I'm gonna put this right here, and then that would leave all of this down here. But if I put it any lower, there's no way I'll be able to reach my arm inside because I'm gonna be doing one of these numbers, okay? So if I put it any lower than that, I'm gonna screw myself over. So I'm gonna go ahead and trace this. All right, so I'm gonna trace this and I'm gonna take my drill and remove material that's within inside that. And I'm gonna put these holes close together. But I do like having it be snug, and then that way this is gonna thread on. Okay, so here's the moment of truth. I'm going to put these two attachments on, and this is why you want to put it within arm's reach or else you've just ruined a barrel. So, all right. That is attached securely. I'm just gonna set that on the base, like so. And then this just goes right in here like this. And then that is going to attach like that. But first, I think that I want to put, because I don't know if we're going to get rain tonight or not, I am going to add a little bit of water into here. You can add pebbles if you want to weigh it down. I went ahead and put some dirt up here and then some pea gravel. And I'm going to take some chia seeds and sprinkle them on the top so that it'll be nice and green and pretty. That's why I went ahead with that height, so that I could get a watering can underneath there and fill it up. I can also use that with a hose as well. So I hope this video was helpful. If you have any questions that I forgot to cover, please leave them for me in the comments. I hope that you'll follow and subscribe here. I'm also on Instagram and TikTok. Please find me there. I'm under my nickname, Miss DeWalt. As always, I thank you so much for watching, and until next time, take care. Hey, today's the next day, and as you can see, the water line is right there. I'm glad I put the drainage holes in because we had a hard rain last night, and this tank is completely full. It's a success. Jeez. Sorry, this isn't the most ladylike thing I've ever done. Come on, Nelly. Oh, that's it, Jen. Why don't you bend down and break it? Okay, well, apparently this needs replaced because it's rot. You know what? Nothing's ever easy.